PM Narendra Modi called upon state governments to work with Union Government as Team India, addressing the third meeting of Niti Aayog's Governing Council held at Rashtrapati Bhavan. PM said that as a former Chief Minister, he is convinced that the vision of New India can only be realized through the combined effort and cooperation of all states and Chief Ministers. PM Modi has urged all Chief Ministers to take care of students from Jammu and Kashmir in their respective states. J&K Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti will meet Prime Minister Modi and Home Minister Rajnath Singh today. AIADMK leader TTV Dinakaran was on Sunday grilled by Delhi police for 11 hours over his alleged attempt to bribe an election commission official for retaining the Two Leaves party symbol. Dinakaran was quizzed for the second consecutive day at the Crime Branch Interstate Cell Office in Chanakipuri. PM Modi on Sunday met Chief Ministers of 13 BJP ruled states. BJP President Amit Shah and parliamentary board members also attended the meeting. Several issues related to governance and development were discussed in the meet. Delhi municipal polls on Sunday saw a voter turnout of 54%. The final tally of votes came in just before midnight as a ward in South Delhi witnessed extremely brisk voting late in the evening. The counting will be held on 26th of April. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has raised the issue of tightening of H-1B visa regime with his US counterpart Stephen Mnuchin. During their meeting in Washington, the Finance Minister also highlighted the contribution of Indian companies and professionals to the American economy. Farmers from Tamil Nadu have called off their strike in Delhi till 25th of May over a drought relief package after an assurance by Chief Minister E. Palanisamy. Palanisamy had met the farmers who had been protesting at Delhi Jantar Mantar and assured them that their demands will be met. The Election Commission of India has issued a letter of intent for purchase of 16,15,000 voter verifiable paper audit trails at an estimated cost of Rs. 3,173 crore during 2017-18 and 2018-19 from two public service undertakings, Bharat Electronics Limited and Electronics Corporation of India Limited. Service charge in hotels and restaurants is not mandatory. Government has approved guidelines on service charge and made it clear that service charge is voluntary. Government says it is unfair practice and the customer may approach the consumer's court. IIMC is all set to launch the first ever postgraduate diploma course in Marathi journalism from its Western Regional Campus in Amravati in Vidarbh region with effect from August 1, 2017. Director General of the Premier Media Training Institute, K.G. Suresh, made the official announcement in this regard at a press conference in Nagpur on Sunday. Centrist Emmanuel Macron and far-right leader Marine Le Pen will face off in the runoff to the France presidential election on 7th of May. The leaders emerged the top two after the French voted on Sunday in the first round of the presidential elections. Britain's immigration officials have detained 38 Indians, including 9 women, for overstaying their visas or working illegally after conducting raids in two clothing factories in the city of Leicester. Of those detained, 31 had outstayed their visas, 7 had entered the country illegally, and 1 was working in breach of their visa conditions. Rafael Nadal won the Monte Carlo Masters for a record 10th time with a dominant 6-1-6-3 victory over fellow Spaniard Albert Ramos Vinolas. It was Nadal's first title in almost a year and he became the first man in the Open era to win the same event 10 times. India's Rohan Bopanna and his Uruguayan partner Pablo Cuevas won the Monte Carlo Masters title after beating 7 seeds Feliciano Lopez and Marc Lopez of Spain 6-3, 3-6, 10-4 in the men's doubles final on Sunday. In a dramatic finish to the game, Bangalore collapsed to 49, the lowest total in the history of IPL, as Kolkata savoured a 82-run victory at the Eden Gardens on Sunday. KKR Pacers rattled the star-studded Bangalore, who found themselves in complete disarray in the chase of a paltry 132.